Today we are discussing the story of a female patient who came to us with cancer of the esophagus. So this is about Mrs. Madhu Yadav from Indore city, a housewife and a mother of two, and who was diagnosed with cancer of the esophagus in 2019 in the month of November. When she came to us, she was bedridden. She could not move about, do her daily activities. She could not eat or drink. And she had also suffered massive weight loss. She had already received chemotherapy and radiation therapy from a reputed hospital in Delhi, and she was still had not recovered from the treatment. She came to us and she insisted that we do Denvax treatment for her, and we started with Denvax treatment. Initially she showed response, good response, and then which later on progressed to complete resolution of the disease.
6 dose lik diye mere, फिर 15 दिन बाद आके मैं ब्लड दे के गई, फिर 25 जनवरी को मेरा पहला डोज लगा। उस टाइम ना मेरी बहुत हालत ख़राब थी, और वो फूड पाइप डाला हुआ था उससे भी ऐसे हो रहा था, पर साहब ने बोला अभी ये 2-3 हफ्ते के बाद निकल जाएगा, इसके बाद तुम खाने लगोगी। तो मैं पानी भी नहीं पी पा रही थी, ऐसे सारा चीज़ देख के लगता था क्या मुँह से कभी खाऊंगी, मैं कभी सोचा भी नहीं था कि मैं मुँह से खाऊंगी।
शी स्टार्टेड टू फील गुड, शी वाज शी हैड स्टार्टेड टू ईट एंड शी कुड शी वाज नो मोर बेड रिडन, शी कुड मूव अबाउट एंड शी कुड आल्सो डू हर डेली एक्टिविटीज।
इनका चलना भी बहुत मुश्किल था, हाँ खुद से चल के जो है थोड़ा दूर चलना 10-20 कदम भी इनके लिए मतलब थकान महसूस होती थी। और इनका एक मतलब जो फर्स्ट डोज यही मतलब 4 दिन बाद इनके काम करने की शक्ति पैदा कर सकता है, तो अब हम तो मतलब यही मानेंगे कि इसके अंदर बहुत ही शक्ति ताकत है जो अंदर अंदर काम किया उसने जो।
और डोज लगाने के बाद उस दिन मैं गई, खूब अच्छे से बैठ गई और अपना वैसे लगा कि हाँ मैं बाहर निकलूँ घूमूँ।
It all started in April 2019 when she had initial complaints of backache and pain in abdomen. She went to her local doctor in Indore who dismissed it as hyperacidity. Her complaints progressed and it was soon followed by difficulty in swallowing, and which later progressed to difficulty in drinking also. So this was also followed by weight loss that she was experiencing because she was unable to eat and drink. Because of this difficulty, she went in to another doctor who did an endoscopy for her and also a biopsy, and wherein this was found that she has a cancer of the esophagus, this squamous cell type of carcinoma, and she was then advised to go to Delhi to seek further treatment. Because of the locally advanced nature of the disease, the tumor was unresectable, and the options left for her were just chemotherapy and radiation therapy. She received 6 cycles of radiation therapy and 36 cycles of chemotherapy. But all this while she was not feeling better, there was no improvement, and she was in the same bad shape as she had when she was starting the treatment. So she came to us, she approached us in January 2020, and we started the treatment for her. We started with Denvax treatment at 15 days interval, and initially there was just a flicker of response, but this progressed to a much better response as the doses increased. She started to feel better. She was now no more bedridden. She could move about. She could perform her daily activities, and she could also eat and drink well.
तो इन्होंने मेरा हर टाइम साथ दिया बच्चों को संभालने में, अकेले ही हमने घर से किसी को नहीं बुलाया, यही मतलब पूरा टाइम मेरे साथ हॉस्पिटल भी जाते थे, यहाँ भी, और बच्चों को भी संभालते थे, हर टाइम साथ दिया उन्होंने।
ये बहुत सरल इलाज है, इसमें कुछ नहीं, आप आराम से लेट जाओ, ग्लूकोज के जैसे बोतल चढ़ा देते हैं और बस, कुछ नहीं है, कोई इफेक्ट भी नहीं, इसके कोई साइड इफेक्ट भी नहीं है, जैसे कीमो वगैरह में साइड इफेक्ट हो जाते हैं किसी किसी की, यहाँ तक कि आदमी की डेथ तक हो जाती है, ये भी हमने देखा है। फर्स्ट डोज लगाया, नहीं समझ में आया, डेथ हो गई, लेकिन इसमें ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है, नॉर्मल है जो है, कोई साइड इफेक्ट है नहीं है, और चमत्कार है एक प्रकार से, तो हम तो ये बोलेंगे कि इसलिए पर चमत्कार है, नहीं तो आदमी का लाखों रुपए खर्च हो जाता है इस हॉस्पिटल से उस हॉस्पिटल, उस हॉस्पिटल से उस हॉस्पिटल में, और ऐसे चक्कर काटते काटते आदमी की लाइफ चली जाती है। और एक किस्मत की बात हम ये बोलेंगे कि हमें ये जगह जो दिल्ली में हम जो आए हैं, हमें किसी ने जो भेजा कि आप दिल्ली चले जाओ, और दिल्ली में आकर के हमें ये जो क्लिनिक मिल गया, ये हमारे लिए भगवान जैसा चमत्कार ही है। ये मंदिर है हमारे लिए जो हम यहाँ पे आ गए और यहाँ बच गए।
She regained her lost weight by about 15 kgs all this while. When she came to us, she also had a stent and a nasogastric tube in place to assist her feeding because she was unable to consume foods through her mouth. Therefore, a nasogastric tube, a Ryle's tube had been placed and to assist the feeding process. And so when she came to us, this was also removed as the treatment started showing response. And as of now, till April 2021, she is doing completely fine. She is leading a normal life. She is able to do all her activities and she can eat and drink just like anybody else.
Ab inki latest report abhi jo hai 27 November ko jo hai abhi karai thi jo hai humne Choitram hospital se hi karai thi jo wahan rehte hain bacche wahi jo hai to bilkul normal hai doctor sahab ne bola koi dikkat nahi hai aur inka abhi vajan bhi jo hai lagbhag 49 kg hai jahan 36 kg tha to 36 kg se badh kar ke 49 kg ho gaya hai.
As for her medical reports, her scans are completely free of disease. There is no evidence of disease. Her PET CT conducted in February 2020 did not show much of a change. However, in the one conducted in May 2020 showed complete resolution of the disease. And another one conducted in November 2020 also shows complete resolution of disease. Also, an endoscopy performed in the year 2020 only in the month of December also shows complete removal of the disease. So there is no evidence of disease, there is complete resolution and she has responded tremendously to the treatment. As far as the current status is concerned, she continues to receive Denvax treatment. She is under our care and observation. Her weight has regained. She is perfectly fine now. A little about the disease. Cancer of the esophagus is cancer of the food pipe, which is the organ that brings food into the stomach. So there are two variants to it. One is the squamous cell type and the other is the adenocarcinoma. Squamous cell type is the one which is found in our part of the world and it is found in the majority of the world, whereas adenocarcinoma is the type of esophageal cancer that is more found in the US or in the Western world. So smoking, tobacco and alcohol, all these have a very strong role to play in the causation of this disease. Also people who are obese or overweight, who are leading a sedentary lifestyle, they are not physically active, and also those who do not eat much of fruits and vegetables, who have vitamin deficiencies, they are also at risk. Also, there is a slightly more predisposition in males compared to females. Also, there is a condition called gastroesophageal reflux disease, which is the food contents they kind of get when they are pushed upwards towards the esophagus from the stomach. Then this kind of leads to irritation in that area of the esophagus, and a chronic condition of a chronic or constant presence of gastroesophageal reflux disease leads to esophageal cancer. This can also cause a condition called Barrett's esophagus, which is a pre-malignant or pre-cancerous condition, and which in due course of time gives rise to esophageal cancer. Also, consumption of hot beverages has a role to play in causing of esophageal cancer. Consumption of hot fluids like hot tea or hot soup on a regular basis, it kind of damages the mucosal lining of the esophagus, and which in turn brings more exposure to carcinogens, and therefore this can also give rise to cancer of the esophagus. The chief complaints of cancer of the esophagus are mostly dysphagia. Dysphagia means difficulty in swallowing of foods or liquids. So initially there is difficulty in swallowing of foods, and this later progresses to difficulty in swallowing of liquids as well, coupled with weight loss. Weight loss is because the patient is unable to eat or drink. The other findings can also be a pain in the bone, which is the sternum bone or the chest pain, and there could also be presence of cough or hoarseness of voice. Now, because there are no screening methods as such, the diagnosis of esophageal cancer usually occurs at a much advanced stage, and therefore it is considered quite a dangerous entity. The good idea is to be an optimum weight, to be physically active, to exercise, to maintain an optimum body weight, and of course to stop smoking, alcohol and consumption of tobacco. Also, not to use very hot beverages when you're drinking tea. Make sure you cool it down, you cool your food down before you consume it. There is a slight propensity of this disease in people who are exposed at workplace. Now, exposure to agents like metal dust, silica, asbestos, or people who work in meat factories or rubber industry or dye industry or wood industry. So these are people, they are exposed to carcinogens, and cancer of the esophagus is also found in these people. Therefore, use of protective equipment and clothing is essential.